here today at the Four Seasons KL to meet up with William Lee to ask him some quick questions. Let's see him. Hello, William.
Oh, hi, Natasha.
Hi, thanks for meeting me at the Four Seasons.
Thanks for coming all the way.
I'm not going to take up too much of your time, so let's make it a quick one, yeah?
Sure, I'll be on my way to the rehearsal later, so if you don't mind, you could start right now.
Sure. So, how many languages do you speak?
I would say 7. Would you like me to list them down?
Sure.
Everything? Okay. Let's start with English, Mandarin, Bahasa, Cantonese, Thai, and Korean. Arasaw.
That's really impressive.
Well, actually, Cantonese is a dialect, so it's just 5.
And how long have you been doing this?
Right since I was born, so it was approximately 21 years ago.
Born with the gift, eh? So, what got you started?
I started with a lot of charity events and I got hooked. I loved the interaction and the rest is history.
What is your most embarrassing emceeing moment?
I forgot my pants.
Are you serious?
Well, it was more or less a wardrobe malfunction. So it was a mismatched blazer and pants, equally as bad.
It could be a fashion statement though.
Hopefully.
Which is your most memorable wedding?
I would have to say a wedding down under at Yarra Valley, Melbourne.
And which is your most memorable wedding location?
The same, Yarra Valley, Melbourne.
Oh, I should visit.
You should one day. But right now, we should visit the ballroom, shall we?
Okay.
Ali, I'll see you at the ballroom later. Hi.
So, are you a morning person or a night owl?
I was made a night owl courtesy of our industry.
Everyone in the industry seems to be a night owl, yeah?
Definitely.
Are you a beer, wine or whiskey person?
Neither. I prefer honey and warm water because it's all good for my vocal cords and some experts say it does get rid of certain diseases.
That is so healthy. Some couples don't believe in hiring professional MC because it's impersonal. What's your take on that?
I think they should meet me because I could get very personal. Well, but the truth is, as long as they are comfortable and they could find a suitable candidate for the job, why not?
Is it important for wedding couples to meet you before engaging your service?
I would strongly recommend if they do have time to meet up with me because we could build rapport before the event and we could have better chemistry on stage at their wedding day.
As you know, most couples would actually be doing their research on MCs before they hire their wedding MC. What should a wedding couple consider when they are deciding on that?
I would have to say good looks.
As long as you don't outshine the groom.
I'm just kidding. Well, they should always look at the right and most suitable style of presentation because there's no one single best MC per se. There's always the most suitable one.
I absolutely agree with that. With all the weddings you've done, do you keep track on how many weddings that you've MC'd over the years?
Well, I do initially, but I lost count after 20,000.
You can't be joking. Can't be serious.
I'm joking. I lost count after a couple of hundreds.
What is the most surprising wedding moment?
Total blackout. Not me, actually. It's actually the lighting. But what happened was we improvised, we brought out all the candles and we solved the problem on the spot.
Wow. And how did you occupy your time during the lockdown?
Well, I did what I couldn't normally do. I sleep a lot, eat a lot, exercise a lot, and repeat.
I think that was what most people did.
Good for everyone.
But did you work on any new materials or jokes during the lockdown?
I tried and I did. Would you like to hear one?
Yes.
Come to my next event.
Ha! Huh. And did you learn a new skill?
I did. Would you like to see one?
Yes.
Come to my next event.
Okay, I look forward to your next event. If you weren't a master of ceremony, what do you think you'll be doing today?
Well, I would most likely be selling seafood online, making big bucks right now.
Well, with your skills, I am pretty sure you can sell anything.
I hope so.
So with that, where do you see yourself 5 years from now?
5 years from now, hopefully happily retired and happily sharing and teaching.
What are your tips to write a good speech?
I would say everything comes straight from the heart. Well, it does help if it comes with a tinge of wit and humor.
Is it harder to host a small wedding or a large wedding?
Well, it depends on a lot of factors, but generally speaking, harder to manage a bigger crowd.
What is the one thing that you'd advise couples to put more focus on at wedding receptions?
This has been often neglected, but what I would have to say is their very own physical and mental well-being, because they have to take good care of themselves to fully enjoy the night.
That is a really good advice. And what is the one thing that annoys you at weddings?
Guests that had a tad too much fun. Drunk guests, to be exact. Drunk guests who love to sing. Perfect combination.
But that makes for a good video though.
Maybe.
What's the next holiday destination on your list?
Let's support Cuti Cuti Malaysia. I would love to go to a place rich with culture and history. Melaka is the spot.
And recommend a wedding destination.
That one, I have to go for Yarra Valley, Melbourne again.
And why did you choose that location?
Picturesque view of the vineyard, great food, amazing people and good weather.
I should really check it out one of these.
You should, for your own wedding, please.
If you can go back in time, what would you advise your 21-year-old self?
Well, that's not too far back, by the way. I would say good things come to those who wait, but while waiting, equip and prepare yourself.
That is also a very good advice. Is there a facade of the industry that you wish you could shine a light on and change it?
I wouldn't say change because I'm not sure I will be bestowed upon such a power, but I would love to see everyone coming together, fighting for our welfare, maybe just sorting out issues, regulating rates and prices, but all for the betterment of our industry.
And lastly, who is your favorite wedding planner?
Tough one, but someone that offers the best experience, and I would have to say you are one of them.
Let the record be known that I did not force you to say that.
You did.
Thank you so much, William.
Thank you, Natasha. See you around.